thank each candidate for coming here tonight and extending to us their platform. And all I can say is, wow, this was a treat. It was a great opportunity for one attendance that took it. Wish you the best when you go to the polls to catch the vote. That hopefully something said here tonight will be beneficial to you at that time. At this time, I'd like to bring Mr. Bruce Allred up to the chamber. Bruce is, I believe, with the chairman of the Chamber of Health.
It's definitely been eye-opening tonight. I hope everybody got a lot of their questions answered. I certainly want to thank every one of the candidates for coming tonight and expressing their hopes for the future. But I also want to make sure that I don't miss saying thank you again to the Valdosta Board of Realtors and for the South Georgia Builder Home Builders Association for sponsoring this event, along with the president's partners. And if you work for one of the president's partners, when I call your name, would you just stand up and remain standing while I go through this list, please? Barnes Healthcare Services, Coleman Dowling, Colonial Bank, Commercial Banking Company, First Federal Savings, Heritage Bank of the South, and Southwest Georgia Bank. Thank you, gentlemen. It's amazing that we're at a political rally and we're going to get through early. So I really want to thank candidates for that. I don't think anybody got a sign, right? So we did really well with that. But I did want to take one moment. As chairman of the Government Mayor's Council, about almost a year ago now, I had an idea that we're going to bring to fruition this next year. Anybody that might be interested in sitting at this panel next year, we're going to actually offer a Chamber Campaign Academy. And what that amounts to is, if open to the public and Chamber members, we're going to bring people in and explain to them how to get involved if they want to run for a public office. You know, initially there will be a meeting where it's just kind of general information. If this is really something you want to do, then we'll have a follow-up class, and we're going to bring in some folks that have been there, done that, to help you understand how and why you might want to run for that office. And I don't mean to, you know, make anybody nervous. We're not trying to run anybody off, but we really believe as a chamber that we have to go out and find business-friendly individuals that want to hold public office. I think that's very important. Somebody made a statement while they were standing up here that government does not create jobs. They do not, and they will not, but business will. We have to have small businesses because they create more jobs than anybody else in this country, and we've got to promote our small business. We've got to give people an opportunity to go into small business. And to do that, we're going to have to create that environment that's been talked about so that we can have more jobs created. I don't care if you only create 5 jobs in your small business. If we do that 100 times, we created 500 jobs. Guess what? The economy goes south. We're probably not going to lose all of you. We get one company with 500 jobs. He goes out of business. What's happened to us? I would much rather see 100 small business people. So please, if you're interested at all in becoming a part of this initiative or consider running for public office, contact the chamber and let us know, because we would love to have you. Other than that, I would again like to say thank you to everybody for showing up tonight. It's very, very important to us that you get out and vote. It's your right. You have an opportunity now to tell people what you want to see happen after this election by voting for the right people. You've got a chance to meet some of them tonight. I hope you got to ask some questions. If not, try to catch them as they leave the stage if you've got one more question for them. Other than that, I want to tell everybody thank you again and have a great evening.